Hi there, hi there. My name is Daniel Makiyama, and this is the Tech Maki channel. The Tech Maki channel was created to talk about system design and coding. So here we're going to talk about very common use cases and how to actually design and implement these use cases. Okay. So the first one that we're going to go over here is order taking, right? So order taking is a pretty common type of use case. So the idea here is for us to think about it from the perspective of the order taking, and not that much at the moment in the perspective of delivering or getting back with the goods right to the customer. Okay, the customer is going to select items from the menu, and after selecting these items, it's actually going to request payment, right? And basically, that's in a nutshell our use case. So in order to do that, first we need to use Visual Studio Code. So Visual Studio Code is going to be our tool for designing as well, right? Not only for coding. In order to download Visual Studio Code, all you need to do is go to code.visualstudio.com. It has you can download that for Windows and also for Mac. So it works pretty well in both operating systems. Okay. So going back here to the Visual Studio Code. Here we have the place where we're going to create the design. And in order to enable creating diagrams here, we are going to add a very interesting extension called PlantUML. For those who don't know what is PlantUML, it's basically a tool that allows you to create UML diagrams just using code, right? So you actually use very simple coding in order to create very nice diagrams, right? So for me, that is I actually really like to code. So having the opportunity to create these visual diagrams without having to draw them and then keep like adjusting and refactoring them, it's a good thing. It's a very good thing. So then the idea is to use this. We're going to use this in our design as well. Okay. So all you need to do is select in the extensions tab here of the Visual Studio Code. You need to type PlantUML, then you click in install. I have already installed, so in my case it's only the uninstall button that is available here. And after you do that, you're going to have to do one more thing, because we're not going to use the sequence diagram for now. For now, we're going to do the first diagram, which is the high level component diagram. Okay, so getting back to that, we need to install then the Graphviz. It's basically what we need in order to create component diagrams in the Visual Studio Code. Okay, so the Graphviz is in graphviz.org, and there is actually a link to download the for Windows, for Linux. So we have like a great support in terms of Graphviz. In my case here that I'm working with Windows, I'm going to download a stable Windows install package. So I'm not going to actually install an MSI. I have just downloaded the zip file and extracted that to a certain folder in my machine. And then I went to the Windows environment variables, and I added here Graphviz underscore DOT, right? And I've added actually the path where a file, an executable file called DOT dot is actually present in my machine. So this is the only thing you need in order to make Graphviz run in your machine. This is for Windows, of course, but you have the instructions here as well for Linux in the website. So getting back to the Visual Studio Code, I of course go file, I'm going to open a folder, and then I'm going to choose a certain folder where I'm going to actually create my diagrams. In this case, I selected a folder in my machine, and you click in select folder, it's going to be an empty folder in my case. Then I'm clicking new file, and then I'm going to give a name for the file, and the extension is what is important, right? So the Visual Studio Code can understand that it's a PlantUML diagram. So the first thing, I'm going to create components.puml. So that's the extension that you need to create in order for Visual Studio Code to understand that this is a PlantUML. So to create your diagram, you need to put at startUML, at the end, you need to define a name for that. So for example, order taking, right? And then you have at end UML. That's what you need to do. And in order to finish your UML. Okay, so here we're going to create a component diagram. So it's important to set brackets to define your components. The first component that I'm going to define is the orders. Okay, so the orders is actually the most important when you're talking about order taking system. Then I'm going to define also a menu, right? So, and I'm going to add use here. So what I'm actually doing here, so by using this, looks like an arrow, right? We are defining that orders uses menu. So what I'm doing is that I'm defining this arrow, so this relationship between orders and menu, and I'm actually adding a label to this arrow. So this is what I do after the column, right? And then I set like use. So this is going to show an arrow between orders and menu, and the label of this arrow is going to be use. If I want to do a dotted line, I put two dots here. And also I can control like the if it's a left arrow, right arrow. I'm not gonna enter in these details. The second thing I'm gonna do is I'm going to define that orders also uses payment, right? For sure, we pay things, right? So it's important that we specify that. And finally, we are going to define that customer actually uses orders, right? So actually, customer uses orders. Great. So that's a very good point here. Like, if we are going to, that's an important point to call out, that if you're going to define in your components, that this is going to host not only one payment, it's going to host many payments. It's actually good if you specify that your component is called payments instead of payment, because it hosts more than one payment. Same thing for the customer, right? If you are specifying that this component will contain all your customers' database, right? Your customers' list of customers, then basically you need to, it's a good practice to actually call it customers. Okay, so the more semantic, the better. So in this case, after you create this diagram, all you need to do is right click and then click in the preview current diagram. You can also use Alt plus D for Windows, but for Linux, that's going to be definitely different. But you right click and then you click in preview current diagram. It's going to render the diagram for you. So here you have customers, they use orders, and the orders use menu in order to select what are the items that are going to be added to the order. And then it also uses payments as soon as the customer wants to close the order, right? Wants to pay. So this is the beginning of the design, starting with the components. So we get a high level view of how what are the basic components of our solution. So in the next video, we're going to show how to create, define actually the properties and also define the functionalities of each of these components. Okay. And we're going to go from there and continue the process of design using PlantUML. If you want me to design and implement another use case, you can put on the comments down below. And don't forget to subscribe and also to hit the bell, because when you hit the bell, you actually know as soon as we publish a new video. Okay, so thanks a lot for watching and see you soon in the next video. Thank you. Thank you very much.